Hello friends, in last video I have told about the how to create a professional resume by using different 10 steps. In today's video I am going to explain in brief how to write a covering letter for your dream job, and here I am also giving a checklist so with the help of which you can write your covering letter for a particular job. So friends, first I will show the structure of cover letter. So here this is the contact details here. Then later on you have to write down your about that the hiring manager, department information. Then later on opening paragraph, and that make it personal to tailor for a particular job or according to job. Then this is the main part of your cover letter, that is the body, and then closing paragraph, and finally formal salutation. So these six parts, these are the main parts of the structure of a cover letter. So all of you know that cover letter, you send it with your resume. So that's why this cover letter, it is a supporting document for your resume when you are applying for a particular job. And you have to also take care of that, so there is no repetition of the particular information about you which is already present in resume, and again you are writing in your cover letter. So this should not be happen. So that's why you have to take care of that, or you have to keep in mind all these things here. So this is the checklist for the writing of cover letter. So when you are writing your cover letter, then you have to check all these things here. And the first thing which is should be checked, that does your cover letter heading include all essential information. So whether you have written properly your full name, then your professional email ID, your phone number, date, then relevant social media profiles. For example, you can put here your LinkedIn profile. Then do you address the right person, that is the hiring manager of that particular company or your future direct supervisor? So that you have to also mention here, or you have to check here. Then does your introductory paragraph grab the reader's attention? So this is very important, because if you grab the reader's attention, if you grab the HR manager's attention, then he will put your resume, or that will be shortlisted. Otherwise, if you are not attracting that reader's attention or that employer's attention or HR manager's attention, so later on he will not see your resume also. So that's why your cover letter should be such that will grab the reader's attention, or that should grab that attraction of hiring manager. So did you mention 2 to 3 of your top achievements? So for this, or for the attraction of reader's attention or that HR manager's attention, you have to mention your 2 to 3 top achievements. Then did you use numbers and facts to back up your experience? So that is very important. When we are working in a particular company, for example, so what exactly you have did there, that you have to mention, and you have to use the numbers as well as facts to back up your previous experience. Then you have to check, do you successfully convey that you are the right person for the job? So that you have to, that should be depend on your that covering letter. And at that time, did you identify the core requirements? Because you have to check whatever the particular job description is there, job requirements is there, whether you have mentioned that in your cover letter, that you have to check. Then did you successfully convey how your experiences help you fit the requirements perfectly? So that you have to again mention here, ki whatever that experience you are having, whatever that working experience you are having, professional experience you are having, whether it convey that hiring manager that you are the right person for the particular job or for that job here. Then do you convince the hiring manager that you are passionate about the company you are applying to? You have to also think about this. You have to also mention like this here. So, and you have to check, did you identify the top 3 things that you like about the company? So when you are applying for in a particular company, then you have to know about that particular company. That may be history, that may be good things from that company. Like that you have to identify or you have to recognize. And you must mention all these things, at least or top two things in your covering letter. Then, did you avoid generic reasons for explaining your interest in the company? So, don't mention that reasons which will not like to that hiring manager or to that employer. So, that you have to check here. Then, did you finalize the conclusion with a call to action? So, that you have to also keep in mind. And finally, you have to check, did you use the right formal closure for the cover letter? So, formal closure should be there, as we have seen in the previous slide, that is in the structure of cover letter. And you can mention here or you can write here regards, thanking you, like that. So this will be your formal closing of the your cover letter. Thank you.